Hit it. The government you have elected is inoperative. Come again. The government you have elected is inoperative. The government you have elected.
The day begins with a prayer and a prayer to excuse my sins. I can walk anywhere I choose, cause everybody listens to the BDP crew. We're not here for glamour or fashion, but here's the question I'm asking. Why isn't young black kids taught black? They're only taught how to read, write, and act. It's like teaching a dog to be a cat. You don't teach white kids to be black. Why is that? Is it because we're the minority? Well, black kids, follow me. Genesis chapter 11 verse 10 explains the genealogy of Shem. Shem was a black man in Africa. If you repeat this fact, they can't laugh at you. Genesis 14 verse 13, Abraham steps on the scene. Being a descendant of Shem, which is a fact, means Abraham too was black. Abraham born in the city of a black man called Nimrod, grandson of Ham. Ham had four sons. One was named Canaan. Here, let me do some explaining. Abraham was the father of Isaac. Isaac was the father of Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons, for real, and these were the children of Israel. According to Genesis chapter 10, Egyptians descended from Ham. 600 years later, my brother, read up. Moses was born in Egypt. In this era, black Egyptians weren't right. They enslaved black Israelites. Moses had to be of the black race because he spent 40 years in Pharaoh's place. He passed as the Pharaoh's grandson, so he had to look just like them. Yes, my brothers and sisters, take this here song. Yo, correct the wrong. The information we get today is just whack. But ask yourself, why is that?
I'm sorry. The government you have elected is inoperative.
Rapper is done. Knowledge reigns supreme over nearly everyone. The stereotype must be lost, that love and peace and knowledge is sore. Do away with that and understand one fact. For love, peace must attack. And attack real strong, stronger than war, to conquer it and its lore. Mental pictures, stereotypes, and fake history reinforces myths.